blockchain. As part of the research labs, we are evaluating blockchain technology since 2017. We are always keep looking at how we can improve the space by applying blockchain technology. By the beginning of the year, three of my co-workers and me set out and founded the Asure Foundation, with the goal to research and develop, promote social security systems on blockchain and see if there is any value in doing that. So as it turns out, social security systems have a big impact on economic and social development in countries. And if you look at the numbers, there are still over 400 billion people that don't have access to social security systems. And we kind of thought, okay, maybe like we can do something there. And by using the blockchain, can we enable or can we bring more access to these people so they can benefit from it? And especially what there are for benefits by doing so. This is why we set out and we decided to first look at pay-as-you-go pension systems and how to port these to the blockchain. We start with pension systems because like they, of all social interests, these have the biggest economical impact. And also, we decided to look at the pay-as-you-go financing method because first of all, we think it's a good fit to the blockchain because you don't have to invest the money in the capital market. A lot of countries in Africa and also in Germany, which is where we're from, use these financing methods. So, yeah, that's first of all, it was like we know this system very well, and second, a lot of countries use them, so we saw a lot of potential there. In Germany, we kind of have a problem with the pension system today because a pension system kind of depends on the birth rate or actually on the ratio of how many people pay into the system to the ratio of how many pensioners you have. So in Germany, the numbers don't look very good today. But for example, if you look at Africa, these numbers look much better. So we are kind of optimistic that for the foreseeable time, pension systems based on pay-as-you-go financing method could work really well there. This is why we set out and we decided to get our hands dirty and create a prototype for a pension system because we are very familiar with the German one. We built the German one. And if you look at a pension system that is financed by a pay-as-you-go method, it works like this, that the employee and the company, in some cases, pay into a specific percentage of the income into the pension system and get pension points in return. And once they retire, the pension points are used to calculate the pension they get. And it's basically just collecting the money of all employees over the course of a month and redistributing the money to the pensioners. And it turns out it's really a good use case to implement as a smart contract because there's nothing more to it. In some cases, there's the government who comes up with all the money that is missing. And in Germany, that's the case, and they put every money that's missing, they put in from tax, basically. So this is because they also make certain guarantees how much pension you will get. This is just the direct part of the German pension system we did, and this is not really autonomous in any way, and because the government still is in control of the parameters and like wants to reform it. And because we really believe in like decentralized autonomous companies and organizations, we took a look and built a second prototype where we tried to remove the control of the government and build kind of an autonomous pay-as-you-go pension system. And the big challenge there is that normally the pay-as-you-go financing methods must be mandatory, so you can kind of guarantee a stable income in the future, which is not the case there if you remove that component, which is why we kind of try to tokenize the pension points and incentivize people to join the system earlier, pay longer, and retire later, basically. Yeah, this is a prototype we built on East Berlin, and we were, the results were kind of interesting. We have to do like more work on that and more research to really figure out if that's like a viable option to do. So yeah, we're really interested in that and where that will end. What we learned from our building these two prototypes is that we think this financing method, the pay-as-you-go, works really well on blockchain because, as I said, you don't have to take money out of the system and have to invest it anywhere. And if you look at like larger communities, for example, like a whole country, and imagine you want to introduce a pension system for Germany, then it would require a lot of transaction, and we assume like a worst case of one transaction per month per user, so result in 17 million transactions. So depending on how large the community is, you want to introduce these pension systems, you need a lot of transactions. And we don't think it's viable or feasible to implement that on Ethereum mainnet, which is why we are currently working on the Asure network. And the basic idea behind the Asure network is what the industry goes today. Not every use case has to be on the Ethereum mainnet. You can split out specific use cases and host them on their special proposed blockchain and just connect them back to the Ethereum mainnet to make assets flow between them. This is where we go in our vision. In the future, you might be able to set up Asure network specifically for a social security system for your community. If it's a small community, a town, a country, it will be very interesting for us to see in which direction that goes. If you want to know more about what we do, about the Asure network, want to talk about social security, I guess we have some time to ask some questions. Follow us on Twitter if you like. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Do we have any questions in the audience for Fabian? Again? Very good.
And again.
There you go.
Give
it a try. If it doesn't work.
Maybe I'm being really stupid here, but don't all pension systems depend on some kind of investment? So even a pay-as-you-go system
depends on a government investing it basically in infrastructure in the country, basically paying it back out when the promises need to be kept.
So, I think basically, so the German pension system, there is no money invested in the capital market. It's really just a pure pay-as-you-go system. Like, the money that goes in gets redistributed right away. And there is some money missing, which comes from the government. This is true. There is only money missing because the government makes certain promises about how much we guarantee your pension. For example, in our prototype, when we remove the government component, we are not able to like, get money from nowhere, so we can obviously only redistribute what people pay into the system. But many people use that kind of a mixed scheme. I'm not sure if you mean that like some capital is invested or not.
Well, I think you want the favorable situation is that a pay-as-you-go system starts with some people start paying in before they go. Otherwise you'll just end up with a kind of a redistributive system where exactly just continually subsidizing it. And with a pension you're supposed to be saving for
something and that
money is supposed to go somewhere. So you're missing a lot of money here basically.
That's the problem.
You don't need to have the problem if you start with a group of people who aren't yet retired, right? And they pay in, and then you've got a fund, and then you can pay it back out to them, and then you do it like that. But yeah, I get it.
I, 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 love to talk with you too, over there.
Thank you. I'd like to lecture a politician.
Well, we've got the same thing in the UK.
So we resolved this political issue later in the coffee break. Thank you very much. Another.